Hello and welcome to a lesson or a presentation on AMD concept and trading inside of consolidations. I'm gonna try to tie in the AMD concept with a Power 3 concept, and I'm actually thinking of dropping this on Twitter instead of YouTube, but I'm not sure. It depends on the length, so I'll figure out the best platform to drop the video on. But let's go into what an AMD concept is. So AMD simply stands for accumulation. Manipulation. And distribution. And if you take the first letter of each word, you get your AMD concept. Now let's go into what the AMD concept actually is. When price is in a range, I usually call that a liquidity base, which is a term I coined from one of Chris Lurie's content or video. Actually, that's what Chris Lurie calls consolidations, right? Liquidity bases. And inside of consolidations, the market is neutral. So the market is neither going higher nor lower. Now, what usually this does in terms of a sentiment play, which is what we're trying to discuss in respect to the model, is that it engineers sentiment in price. Now, classically, what retail would do is they would chase the expansion out of a consolidation. Now, one thing which is a huge mistake I see a lot of traders make is that they see consolidations and they think every break out of a consolidation is a fake out. Okay, not every break out of a consolidation is a fake out. You have to put that consolidation in context of order flow or price delivery. Before I go into that lesson, let's talk about what the accumulation, manipulation, and distribution cycle actually is. With the AMD model, what you have is a classic consolidation price. And what the market would do a lot of times, if you study consolidations, is the market will make a false move out of the consolidation, right? Now remember, we have four market profiles. We have consolidation profile, we have a retracement, we have breakout, it could be true breakout or false breakout, and then we have the expansion, right? So inside of this model, what would follow logically is a breakout. Now, our job is to qualify if the breakout is true or false, and we're going to talk about how you can qualify the breakouts. But when you see a sudden run higher, or when retail sees a sudden run higher, in this example, out of consolidation, they are chasing the longs because the textbook teaches you to either buy on a buy stop, the breakout of a range, or buy the retracement back into the what they'll consider as resistance, right? So retail look at this as resistance, and they want to go in and buy the retracement of the resistance, and then they're looking for consolidation prices higher, right? So this is classically what retail expects in price. It's also the same way they trade double bottoms, right? Because I've studied all these concepts. That was what I was sharing with before. So with the double bottom concept, once the market breaks above the neckline, you want to buy the retest back into the old resistance, which is, should now be support, and you're looking for higher prices. And that's the same concept with, in terms of retail, with trading consolidations. They're either buying the breakout or they're buying the retest into the original range. Now, usually what the market would do is the market, if it intends to run for, or if it intends to pair against counterparty liquidity, so that could be in form of high time frame swing low here. So we're gonna call that a daily low in price. So we already know that the market would want to ideally reach for the sell side liquidity down here in line with the daily program. Now, when I see runs like this, retail would chase the run higher, buying above the range, and they'll put protective stops below where they think is support, which is going to be all of these candles down here. So what the market will do is the market will drive price higher. Again, it's not due to buying pressure or selling pressure. This is all just simply algorithmic run for counterparty liquidity, or to induce or engineer open flow liquidity. Well, open flow liquidity is a market engineer. It is engineering open flow liquidity on the sell side, because the intended direction is around for sell side liquidity. Okay, so they'll run the market higher, and then retail chases the buys, and they'll sell into retail's buy. Okay, so who are the individuals who are selling? Right, it's going to be interbank traders. It's going to be institutions. They'll pair their sells against what retail is buying, right? And then the algo starts to drive the market for counterparty sell side liquidity. And in the process, also run for the ultimate sell stop resting down here. Now, this is classically where you get your breakout pattern, where the market would run above a short-term high, break lower. Usually, it might not. You might not see a significant retest of the breakout block. And I'm hoping you don't know what a breakout block is. If you don't know what a breakout block is, just ignore. It's not really that important for this lesson. We're discussing this concept or this model here. Now, inside this price delivery structure here, this is where our AMD model comes into play. Our consolidation is the accumulation phase of the model. Our false expansion is the manipulation phase of the model, and our true expansion is our distribution phase, our distribution cycle. Now, I'm sure it's very easy for you to look at this as a week of model, where you have your spring and your test and jumping the creek and all of those things. But this is not a week of model. This is really straightforward. It's easier because I used to trade week of two before. Okay, this is easier to understand and it's easier to anticipate. Whereas with the week of model, you know, it is a lot of gray area in price. Okay, so this one is more specific in terms of price delivery. So you have your accumulation, which is where the market creates a small little range and builds up order flow, not order flow, sorry, builds up liquidity in price. Okay, inside the accumulation cycle, the run out of that range builds sell side liquidity, and then at the same time, sellers inside the range, they're neutralized, because inside this range there's a whole lot of transactions going on. There's buyers inside this range, there's also sellers inside the range. As the market expands higher, the sellers in the range, they're triggered, their subs are triggered, okay, or their counterpart liquidity is triggered, and then at the same time, but more buyers are induced at a premium here. All right, so relative to this range, this is a premium. So at extreme premium, which is outside this consolidation, buyers are induced. So the market induces buyers to go long at a premium and then puts the brakes on them in aggressive runs for sell side liquidity. So the consolidation is the accumulation cycle. The initial run or false break out of the consolidation is your manipulation to induce liquidity, and then distribution is the actual run for counterparty parent of liquidity, which is going to be an external liquidity to the consolidation. And that's where you get your accumulation, manipulation, and then distribution cycle. Now, this kind of price of a profile occurs every single day, okay, or almost every single day. And you can see that with your Asian range and your London session profile. This is classic London session price delivery. So I'm going to go to just a random currency, and we're going to use, I'm looking for a good pair we could use. Let's see what we could use. We could use pound CHF. All right, that's a very obscure pair. I don't really trade. And I'm sure I don't really need to look much to identify the model for London. So London, my time starts around 6. But you can use, in terms of Eastern Standard Time, start between 1 a.m. Eastern to 5 a.m. Eastern. That's your window of opportunity for trading London session. So, but in my time, it is 6. All right, so between this time and this time is my London kill zone. Look at what the market does out of London. Isn't that the same profile I just showed you? Again, I'm putting up a random pair. I'm not selecting or anything. we have consolidation inside of London, an aggressive run lower, which is the manipulation cycle, which induces counterparty liquidity. Here, a premium. Here, a premium. Okay? And then retail goes in and they are selling the most discounted prices. And then the market aggressively puts the brakes on them and then runs for the counterparty liquidity. That's what the market does for Friday's price delivery. We go back and look at Thursday's price delivery and we delineated London session. And this in and of itself is a model. This actually is a model itself. Okay, now there are more things you can add to the model. I'm just discussing the concept of a power of three play. So you can see going into London session, we have a consolidation, very tight consolidation. The market aggressively runs below short-term low. Retail will sell short below here. They're looking at this as a run in continuation of order flow. And that creates a pulling of counterparty buy stop liquidity above this eye here, above this eye here and here. And you can see how the market violently runs for the counterparty liquidity. So it runs lower, induces liquidity, shifts order flow, runs for retail stops. If I went all the way back, you can see how this phenomenon repeats itself over and over and over and over again, right? It repeats itself. Now in this example, you have a consolidation. I'm gonna delineate London session and the end of London session here. And what you have here is you have a consolidation, okay? Consolidation and then the market displaces. Why was this not a power three where the market runs lower and then puts the brakes and runs higher? And this is where your real learning this is where your real education comes into play. Power three only works in context of order flow and in context of anticipated drawn liquidity. Without understanding or without a clear or proper understanding of where price should reach for, your power of three logic is useless. And I see a lot of you guys, especially on Twitter, there's so many educators on Twitter right now. Everyone is an educator on Twitter. Once you get a funded account, once you pass one funded account, you're already an educator, you know? That's what everyone's doing. And when they're teaching concepts like this, they don't have enough experience to navigate concepts like this. And what they'll do is they'll go into every price action looking for a power of three setup. And in this one here, they would expect the market to maybe trade out into this as a bullish order block and see expansion for what they think is buy side liquidity. The reason why this should not be a power of three and going into London session, this is fine, is because daily order flow is bearish. So if you go out on the daily time frame and look at price delivery on the daily time frame, what is the daily order flow doing? You can see we have a short-term high here, which is the external liquidity of this range. I think on the course we did a forecast on this expecting weakness in price. I think it's on the course. So go and check, I can't remember exactly what video, but I used this for an example to do a forecast in price. But you can see how the market runs a buy stop or buys liquidity. What do you think is going up there? There's counterparty pairing of liquidity or distribution going on there. The market runs lower into a bullish order block or discount. This is a run higher into a premium, which is the last of candle prior to run lower, which is this bearish order block. It shows no willingness in price to trade through the bearish order block. And then what you can see here is we have this candle close lower than this candle. This becomes a bearish order block. If this becomes a bearish order block, where is the target drawn liquidity? These lows down here. This is a low resistance liquidity run signature. This is a high resistance liquidity run signature because of all the back and forth in price here. You can see this eye, and this one runs higher, then this one runs higher, and then this one runs higher one more time before displacing lower. Okay, so the market should have ease running for the lows here because they are relatively clean lows on a daily time frame. And if you read price via order flow, you can see order flow is bearish. How can you define order flow? What is the market respected? Is it respected premium or is it respected discount? It goes up into a premium. This shows willingness to displace away from a premium. Now remember, if we see displacement from key higher time frame PDRs, that is institutional sponsorship. We can see institutional sponsorship by the willingness and price to want to displace lower. So we already know that daily order flow is bearish. By understanding that daily order flow is bearish, when we look at consolidations and price, we don't go in and say we are looking for the market to trade lower and that's an opportunity to go long and we're looking to buy. It just don't make sense. Okay. Instead, this consolidation would make more sense because it is coming above a short-term buy stop. Okay. We have a short-term high here and we have equal lows down here. What do you think this is in terms of retail logic? This is a support, right? This is what I used to learn from IML 2017, 2018, early 2018, when I was in IML. We're learning patterns like this. So we have support here and we have what retail would consider resistance. Now, if the market is expanding away from support, we want to see the market trade up into resistance because this is resistance in price. And that's so, yeah. Now, we have a short-term high here, which is resistance. As soon as the market breaks that resistance, what does this become? It becomes support. So retail views this consolidation as a buy opportunity. We view this consolidation as a sell opportunity. So you don't expect a power of three higher to then sell off. If the market is already at external liquidity, where that should see displacement lower. This is trading inside of consolidations. So we have a short-term low and we have a premium. And if you want to define premium, just simply take your range profile, use your eye to low. All right, you can see we're above the equilibrium of the range and we're at premium. So the market makes a short-term high just above premium and then runs above that. Retail is buying this. We already understand that the general liquidity should be on the sell side. All right, the market should be reaching for these lows down here because those are very clean lows. So we can go in during London session. We have a bearish order block. We have a propulsion block here. We can go and sell the propulsion block. Now I've said you want to look for the Judas swing. A Judas swing is that manipulation phase of your AMD model, which is the accumulation, manipulation, and distribution. Because classically, Asia would have a consolidation, London session would have a false displacement, which is what we'll call market protraction, and then the true displacement actually starts. Right? That usually occurs during the first 1 or 2 hours of London session. But excuse me, in a profile like this, we don't expect that protraction. This is what we call London delayed protraction. I taught this on model on the short-term trading course. I taught about delayed protraction, and a delayed protraction is where you don't see a significant jitter swing from London open into the marketplace. And I define conditions where you can anticipate that. Okay, you can already see here, prior to London session, we have done the manipulation. So it does not make sense for us to run higher one more time, especially with the lows resting down here. So once you see displacement in price lower, you can see the market displaces here. And even if you're scared to go in and sell short there, you can wait for the market to come back into the propulsion block, which it never does actually, all right, as a premium. So either the propulsion block or the small little fair value gap here, and you can sell short there and use yourselves above the propulsion block. Because you don't want to see the market trade back up above this one. If it trades back up above the high there, it loses the retail liquidity or the buyers are trapped up here. Again, the understanding of price is all about logic in terms of where the market should be displaced into, and then timing in terms of your kill zone timing session, and then looking for the narrative. And the narrative is understanding how price engineers counterpart liquidity. So this run higher during Asia was just to engineer more sell side below this low here. And if you're looking at this as equal eyes, this is not an equal eye. Rather, we had a run on buy stops. okay? You can see here the previous day, where the shorts am I? Because our anticipation is bearish, it makes sense that this run higher is a false run. The market runs higher, retail chases the longs. Sell side liquidity is what the market wants to attack. And you can see what time is this occurring? It is occurring during London open. Again, this is London closing. So I've shown you 4 days back to back to back to back of the same model repeating outside this one here. This one just came a little bit early because it happened during Asia. And if you're wondering, how is this a power theory model? This is a range, that's a consolidation. This is your manipulation. This is your distribution. When this model occurs outside of London session, before London open, in line with order flow, aka the manipulations occurring against order flow, and you're expecting a near-term drawn liquidity, once you start to see the displacement for London session, you can trust that. So again, I'm not necessarily advocating for you to go and sell short here the proportion candle, right? I can do that, but you can wait for the market trade up into a premium here, okay? And you can sell short at the fair value gap, targeting the sell stops here, because you know what, that's where the market is reaching for. If I went on an even lower time frame here, and let's just delineate London session and do more narrative in price, you can see here is the target drawn liquidity, even though we still have a lower drawn liquidity. But for now, here's target drawn liquidity. We have a range here, power three, consolidation, market runs higher, induces counterparty pairing of liquidity, starts to deliver cycle lower, and you know the algo is going to draw the market down into sell side liquidity. So we have a 5 minute inefficiency here. The market trades up into that prior to the run on liquidity. That's your opportunity to go short. If you sell short there, what will your stops be? You don't want to see the market trade above the saw here, so you can put your stops above this bearish block here, and you're aiming for sell stop. The market offers you that profile and you're done, right? Now, if you look even closer in price, you can see a power through model. What power through model can you see? Consolidation. Breakout. Who is buying the breakout? Retail. They're buying the run out of consolidation. You're going to see that the run higher or the manipulation phase usually is going to be against order flow. That's what you like to see. As the market runs higher, usually will run to a level of premium. Then you can short that or fade it while retail chases that. Because retail, again, this is a short-term low here. And if you extend this low out in price, you can see this to retail would be support, right? Because that's what they teach you. Price, remember old levels in price, and that is support, and you want to buy support, or you want to buy the retest, which you can see what the market does here. It trades back down into original consolidation, shows a willingness like it wants to trade higher. Retail gets sucked in with this candle pattern, so retail will trade candle patterns. They look at this as weak rejection against the consolidation. You're buying the candlestick patterns, and then the market just puts the brakes on them and aggressively slams down hard and lower. I also wanted to segue into dollars price action. Now, recently, if I go and pull up a chart of dollar, we've seen a very strong order flow or trend on US dollar below that 100 level, significant P day rate. Now in the process, you can see that we were stuck here. And if you go back and watch my commentaries, I was explaining how to navigate a condition like this. I was explaining that we were looking for a weakness in dollar, but again, we had to wait, right? And in terms of trading consolidation, that same concept that I just taught you in terms of the accumulation phase, manipulation phase, and then distribution phase, this is what I was teaching with dollar during this specific week. So I want you to go back and watch the commentaries. And I was telling you to anticipate that kind of profile, right? So if you go in and look at price, you can see we have a consolidation. And then we have a run out of the consolidation, which is this candle here. this run, again, this is not a short-term time frame. This is a daily time frame. This run was a run into a premium, which is a body of this bearish order block. Market runs higher there. What do you think Reuters is doing is as the market runs and opens up above that? They're excited about the longs because you can see market structure is low, higher high, higher low, higher high, higher low, higher high, because that's what retail does. And this is why I preach against trading only structure, because if you're trading only structure, at points in price where the market reverses, you are trapped, okay? You get trapped in price. And the market traps you, runs one direction. Let me switch connection real quick. I think the power went out. So I think we should be back. All right, so the market runs aggressively in one direction and then puts the pause in retail who are chasing the longs, or they're chasing the buys. And guess what happens next? Distribution. So you have your smaller the range where the market runs higher. And at the same time of price running higher, Treasury's market was failing, or Treasury's market was running aggressively lower, but we saw that lack of willingness on trade higher dollar, and I actually covered this on my commentary, right? And that's the thing with consolidations. When prices is in consolidations, usually on the higher time frame, you're going to see lower time frame decoupled markets or disparity. So disparity essentially means a lack of symmetry in price. And you've seen me cover this all throughout the year, whereby the market is in consolidation. And I will teach you, or I usually tell you, anticipate the market being in consolidation because you're seeing a lack of correlation with this asset and then this asset and then this asset. And that's what the market actually does, right? So you can anticipate consolidation ahead of time just by watching price symmetry around, you know, ranges, right? So you can see here, if I pulled my Fibonacci, again, I'm not using the week of the scandal because that's around the stops, right? So I'm ignoring this eye here and I'm taking the ISI in this candle, which is here, and I am taking the low here. When price is at equilibrium, usually it will build sentiment, right? And building sentiment essentially means if the market is at equilibrium of a trend range, it could go higher, it could also go lower. So what the market will do is the market will go into consolidation oftentimes and show this model. Again, don't take my word for this. Just go and listen to the commentaries on this specific date. Okay, look for 3rd of July, 4th of July, 5th of July, and watch the live sessions of videos where I was explaining the market doing exactly this profile. Okay, and you can see how the distribution came after on. And we were aiming for sell-side liquidity. And you know what happened after all of that, where we just aligned ourselves with order flow and made tons of money. So I'm going to end this presentation or lesson here. And hopefully this was insightful. I'll catch you on the next one. Trade safe.